you might be getting the impression that there's lots of evidence for a single thing called general intelligence, G, because that's what the Raven's progressive matrices and other tests are designed to measure. There is actually a way whether we can basically tell whether intelligence is one thing or multiple things, and it's to do with comparing people's performance on many different tests of intelligence, like Spearman did, using a statistical technique called factor analysis. This is an advanced statistical technique, so I'm just going to briefly outline the basics. I'll be simplifying things terribly here. Really, all I'd like you to take away from this is the underlying concept of factor analysis, not how to do it or how to interpret the results from a factor analysis. Now, imagine that we have a couple of tests, and we measure people's performance on those tests, and we plot them on a graph like this as a correlation. We could plot a line there that's designed to summarise those scores and reduce the error as much as possible in summarising those scores. We can see how much error there is by looking at where the individual responses fall in relation to that line. What do you notice as the scores get larger? What happens to the amount of error as the scores get larger? So what I'm asking is, how far away are the scores from the line? Well, the amount of error seems to increase as the scores get higher. The points of data get further and further away from the line. The scores seem to be clumping together more down here, but they're spreading out more apart up there. Therefore, this might suggest that using a single correlation or factor is not the best way to describe this data. What factor analysis does is it looks at whether one, two, or even three factors better describe the data. It goes up to any number it needs to describe the data. How you know when it's adequately describing the data is the variation around those factors is reduced to a statistical minimum. It's not eliminated, but there's an optimal number where adding more won't get rid of any more error. So we can statistically tell what number of factors we need to represent these scores. The idea is, if we give people a bunch of intelligence tests, we do factor analysis on their performance, we should be able to work out how many factors we need to describe their performance. These statistical factors map onto how many factors intelligence has. If we can use a single line to represent their performance, then there's a single factor we might call G for general intelligence. If we need seven lines to represent their performance on the test, then there's seven underlying factors to intelligence. Using factor analysis, we can work out statistically the number of factors we need to describe intelligence. In 1938, Thurstone conducted a factor analysis of 56 tests to determine the nature of intelligence. So instead of two-dimensional space like the example before, imagine 56-dimensional space and doing a factor analysis on that. Thurstone found seven factors underlying intelligence from the 56 tests. These factors included verbal comprehension, verbal fluency, number, spatial visualization, memory reasoning, and perception speed. Therefore, the conclusion at the time was that there were seven discrete aspects to intelligence. Now, you can imagine people who are sort of already committed to thinking about this notion of general intelligence. This would be a bit of a worry for them in terms of evidence, because it's quite inconsistent with the idea of G. In 1966, Horn and Cattell performed a factor analysis on Thurstone's seven factors. Instead of finding seven factors like Thurstone found, they found two higher-order factors that describe performance across those seven factors. They called those higher-order factors fluid intelligence, or GF, which is performance on culture-free tasks like Raven's progressive matrices, and crystallised intelligence, or GC, which is tasks requiring some sort of prior information. For example, what's the capital of France? Horn and Cattell suggested that you need both of these to describe test performance because both of those, although they're related, are not the same thing. Here's an example of some fluid intelligence items. These items are a little bit more extensive than just progressive matrices. For example, you have to pick which of these belongs there. In case you're playing along at home, the answer is number four. There are also questions that assess analogies, but these don't require a lot of comprehension of cultural concepts. Here you've got to choose something to complete this sequence. A square is to a triangle as four vertical lines is to, I'll let you think about it for a second. The answer is three vertical lines because of the number of sides. A lot of these questions tap into different abilities, but they do it in a way that doesn't necessarily rely heavily on cultural knowledge.